No U-Turn takes you with us to Pondicherry, also called Puducherry. It's a union territory on the southeast coast of India, surrounded by Tamil Nadu. And while we take a pit stop for some refreshing morning tea, Pondicherry's history. Well, primarily a French colony, started somewhere around the 1600s and has been influenced majorly by the French colonization and the French East India Company. Let's take a look. We are approaching Pondicherry from Chennai and we have taken the East Coast Road, very, very scenic road lined with palm trees. And eventually, as you near the city, the palm trees give way to these concrete structures. And since we are nearby, we will also cover Mahabalipuram on this trip. Stay tuned. When you're in the south of India, get up early and don't miss their breakfast. It's so yummy. We were passing this stall and the aromas were simply captivating. Just look at this vada and the most fluffy idlis that we've ever had, with fresh coconut chutney and sambar. That's the perfect way to start the day. And as we gobble down these steaming hot delicacies, we can't resist the upma. The upma served with sambar and again, the fresh white and red chutneys. Awesome stuff. So here are the streets of Pondicherry. Now, point to be noted, not the whole of Pondicherry looks like this. This is the so-called French-influenced portion of Pondicherry, and a larger portion of Pondicherry is like any other South Indian town. Many of the villas that line these streets are vintage Mediterranean-style villas. They are huge, they have balconies, there are a lot of open spaces, and typically were inhabited by the French when they colonized this area. This place is family friendly and it also attracts a lot of spiritual tourism. There you see the Aurobindo Ashram. This was the house of Sri Aurobindo, the Indian philosopher, yogi and guru. And it also has the samadhis of Sri Aurobindo and the mother. It also has a huge library and a beautiful sit out where you can sit and read. Next stop was the Pondicherry Museum. Beautiful artifacts, many centuries old. I particularly love the vintage furniture and the vintage car section. And soon thereafter, we head to the beach road, which holds many of Pondicherry's must-see places. One of them is coming up right in front of you, the Mahatma Gandhi statue. Right behind the statue is the popular beach area. And very nearby is also the old lighthouse. Now, this was constructed sometime in the 1830s. And in its prime, it could be seen from as far as 20 miles from the sea. We are standing on the famous rock beach in Pondicherry and we're wondering how populous these waters would be with trading ships, as Pondicherry was the major trading center for the French East India Company. Staring into the horizon, we also sense we'll see some showers today. For lunch, we visit Les Saviors, one of the most recommended places in Pondicherry for French food. As soon as we entered, it was a wow feeling. The beautiful furniture, the soft yellow lights, the warm ambience. This place had such a positive vibe to it. The ambience is superb and rustic. Just look at these colored glass windows, this amazing curtain with butterflies on it. I think it's a net. And right at the side, you see this cartwheel-shaped window. And the place also has beams and pillars of teak wood with carvings on it. It all comes together so beautifully. As the orders start pouring onto our table, we do a lot of French food, a lot of wine, and a lot of beer. And overall, it was an amazing experience. Check it out. And while we were enjoying our food, the rains took Pondicherry by surprise. Look at these streets, flooded instantly. But that didn't stop us from exploring further. Also very nearby to Pondicherry is Auroville, an experimental town founded around 1960s by Mira Alfasa, who was also popularly called the Mother. And this is a spiritual retreat for many. But we give it a pass today and we'll come back for that later. But today, we're headed to Mahabalipuram. Mahabalipuram is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. It has a group of Hindu temples which are right from the shore inwards and scattered over quite a huge area. So once you get here, be prepared to trek it up. The famous shore temple is right ahead of you, and this one specifically is lined, the wall of this temple is lined by the Nandi bulls. Amazing architecture, and we are just enjoying this lovely sight. Once you trek around the place, you also see the monolith caves. Monolith basically means that these caves are cut out of a single rock. They're cut outside inwards. And just look at the detail on these things. This rock face is extremely famous. And here's what was our main motivation to come to Mahabalipuram. The famous Krishna's Butterball. Right there in front of you is what it is. This is a boulder which is actually balancing on a slope and forms a major tourist attraction and is a major photo attraction. We just couldn't control our emotions when we saw this. It was just so cool. And a couple of stops more around the place, and that sums up our trip to Mahabalipuram. By the way, if you want lovely idols carved out of black rock, this is the place you need to go to. So that brings us to the end of this episode. We hope you enjoyed it. This is No U-Turn, and our channel that brings to you our travels and lifestyle experiences. Do subscribe and be the first one to know when we post new content. We hope you enjoyed the video. Do leave your comments and let us know which part of this video you love the most. Signing off for No U-Turn. See you in the next episode.